Yeah, good afternoon. So this homework number four covers two chapters. Chapter six, noise, and chapter seven, feedback. I think April 8th is Wednesday. Is it Wednesday? 2 weeks from now. Okay. So we'll talk about the noise analysis and feedback frequency compensation. Okay. Yeah, two stage of amp. Two stage of some frequency compensation. Yeah. So three stage amplifier, unity gain feedback. So we'll go over those ones in chapter 7. Okay. Okay, let's just talk about the noise. Yeah, noise. How do you write a noise? Noise is like that, right? See. I think this is a bird. Bird, right? This is a tree. I don't know what this is. Two people. So birds are on the tree. They are noisy. Okay? This is just sound, right? So we need a noise analysis to determine minimum input voltage that can be amplified. Okay? So we calculate the equivalent input noise voltage. We convert the noise of amplifiers into input side. That equivalent input noise voltage is the minimum voltage that can be amplified. It's called the minimum detectable signal. So we look at the noise of resistor, KT of C noise, noise bandwidth, MOSFET noise, equivalent input noise voltage of some circuit, some simple amplifier circuit. Yeah, noise is a random process. Random. Random has so many different translations. So this is a noise waveform. It is random. It cannot be predicted. However, the power, noise power can be predicted. Say, this is average noise power. So I just square it. XT is noise waveform. And then average during time interval of T, average power of noise can be predicted. Instead, instantaneous value cannot be predicted. Yeah, so power spectral density of noise. Yeah, spectrum. So this is my noise waveform. Yeah, this is waveform, right? My waveform. Yeah, this is power spectral density. Power spectral density is in terms of frequency. So yeah, so some frequency component, right? You know, the power, yeah, see, power can be calculated in time domain. Do I have that one? Oh yeah, later. Okay. Yeah, this is XT. Yeah, noise power. We can calculate the power in a time from time domain waveform, or we can calculate the power of power from spectral density. This is a power spectral density, right? Oh, they are the same from Passavage's theorem. So if I integrate all these areas in power spectrum density, that should be my power. So, yeah, see, if I apply a noise with a power spectral density like SXENF through a system, this is my telephone system. Telephone system, say, it may be around 20 hertz, or may not be 20 hertz, maybe 100 hertz to 3.3 kilohertz or something like that. This is my telephone system. Then this 20 kilohertz noise is reduced into 4 kilohertz spectrum, right? So output power spectral density is input power spectral density multiplied by this square of transfer function. This is HF is a transfer function of a system. Yeah, this is a linear time invariant system. Yeah, power is just this, right? So this is for example, this is power spectrum of white noise. Power spectral density 2 KTR. If I use a two-sided spectrum, some noise power, actually, if it extends, let's see, if I use it in a one-sided spectrum, should be 4 KTR. That's a power spectral density of noise, I mean resistor noise, with a resistance value of R. If it extends into the infinite frequency, yeah, that power should be infinite, right? So in reality, it should go to zero somewhere at the very high frequency. That's so high frequency, and we just assume this is infinite white noise. Yeah, our electronics bandwidth maybe is much smaller than this thermal noise bandwidth. We just assume white noise. We mostly use this one-sided power spectral density instead of this two-sided power spectral density. Yeah, correlation. Correlation. Yeah, this is a correlator. You know what correlator is? A correlated. Correlate. How do you write a correlate? Eh? Correlate. Correlate. Actually, they are very similar letter there, right? Very similar. Same letter here, right? Correlate. So if I have a three correlated signal, correlate means, see, they are in phase. Say, I can write x2 equal some constant times x1t. Yeah, it's exactly correlated, right? 100% correlated. If I add them together, say they just multiply in phase. Yeah, they are the same signal, then amplitude becomes 3 times, power becomes 9 times, right? Power becomes 9 times. For uncorrelated signal, yeah, they are not related. Then that amplitude increases a little bit, maybe square root 3 times may increase, right? Amplitude for the power, yeah, power increases 3 times, okay? Power 3 times. Say, this is power of sum of two signals, x1 and x2. Okay, then see, I decompose it, the x1 power, x2 power, And then the correlated component, 2x1, x2, right? If they are correlated, this is twice power, right? Say this is P1, P2. If they are correlated, this may be something like that, right? They are added together. However, if they are uncorrelated, this component go to zero. Uncorrelated. Then for the uncorrelated signal, power becomes twice. For the correlated signal, power becomes four times, right? Thermal noise. Yeah, this is a resistor. You know the resistor. This is a hand, right? Hand. You can see this is my hand. And then this is a low. So this is a kind of defend yourself, because you lower your hands in a lower side, and this is a hand, and this is high. This component. So, you just raised your hand to offend, right? So this thing register is sometimes defend, sometimes offend. Always register, right? So anyway, this register thermal noise. There is an electron, right? Free electron inside the metal or inside some conductor. It has a thermal energy. So because of this thermal energy, it move around. And then it can collide with the atom, right? Inside the metal or inside the semiconductor, there is an atom, right? So free electron collide with the atom and then change direction. If there is some non-zero electric field, and among those collisions, it can move a little bit, right? If there is electric field, it will move that way. Okay, this velocity is called drift velocity, is proportional to electric field, right? Yeah, because of this random motion, if I have a electrode somewhere, for example, this is electrode. Yeah, there is always some in time domain. The current, average current is here, but fluctuation of that current because of those random thermal motion. That's a thermal noise. So that thermal noise is in a one-sided spectrum. Thermal noise is 4 kTr. So this is a power spectrum, right? Not voltage. Power spectral density is like that. So you can see this is what's the dimension of this one? Dimension. KT is energy, right? Energy times KT of Q. KT of Q is volt. What's energy? Voltage. Yeah, this is energy is joule times volt per amp, right? How can I write this one? This is power, right? Joule is should be power watt per hertz or something like that. Is this true? This is a joule, 4 kTr. Yeah, I will think of this dimension later. Should be something like that. Okay, I will check it. Okay. So the thermal noise of this resistor can be represented by this Thevenin form. Yeah, actually, this is not voltage, right? This is a kind of a voltage square. This time the DF is this corresponds to power actually. Then it because this is a voltage square, we can convert it like that. Say this is ampere square, right? Then in that case, this current must be multiplied by R square, because this is also current square. Okay, it's divided by R square, which is 4 kT of R. Okay, so if I put two resistors in series, what should be the equivalent value? Yeah, that equivalent value is it's a series connection. It should be sum of those two. Average value is zero. And then, because thermal noise of R1 is uncorrelated with the thermal noise of R2, this integration of multiplication is zero, because they are not correlated. So, in that way, see, I can see power is just sum of those each power. So in a frequency domain, we can do the same thing, should be R1 plus R2. So it makes sense, right? Those two resistors in series makes R1 plus R2 in resistance value. Noise is also 4 kTr, right? Mu R. Yeah, okay, we'll talk about KT of C noise. Any question? So whose turn is this? Jung Kyung-won. Ming-rong, did you ask question on Monday? Yes, then Jung Kyung-won, ask a question. No? Okay. Let's go to KT of C noise. Say, for the sample hole circuit, say sample hole circuit. We have input voltage here, and then there is a switch resistance, and then capacitor. So those two combination makes a switch, right? Boteng one sided 를 많이 쓰죠. Silsu Hosu? Two sided 로 negative frequency 이런 게 들어가겠죠, 그죠? 근데 그저 파워 스펙트럼 따질 때는 투사이디드로 쓸 수가 있지만 파워 말고 그냥 스펙트럴 덴스티 이거 할 때는 원사이디드가 더 편리해요. 이거 투사이디드 지금 이쪽은 잊어버리고, 그러니까 지금 파워 할 때 인테그레이션 어디에서 파워만 따질 때, 노이즈 파워 따질 때. 근데 안 그러면은 투사이디드 쓰면은 요거죠 요거. 그래서 얘 둘이 같아야 돼 어쨌건. 그래서 원사이디드를 줄었어요. 그냥 4KTR을 줄었잖아. 2KTR 뭐 양쪽이 벌리지 않고, 그제 어떤 때는 뭐 또 아무거나 써도 되긴 돼요. 아, preference, personal preference. 야, see here, there is a sample hole circuit. You know, there is some waveform here, right? This is my VST waveform. I have a sampling clock here, right? Whenever this clock is high, it samples this voltage and store it here, right? That's a sample hole circuit. So, ideally, if I sample and then stay there, and then sample, some stay there, sample, and stay here, sample, something like that, right? That's what sample hold circuit is. It needs some hold for analog to digital conversion, to the conversion process, to perform the conversion process, right? So it must maintain it constant during the conversion process. Otherwise, it will reduce the bandwidth of ADC operation. So anyway, when this is on, the thermal noise of this resistor affect this capacitor voltage. Okay, that noise voltage is also sampled and hold here, right? Noise voltage is included in this hold value, right? So when it's sampling, while the switch is on, the thermal noise voltage is transferred to the capacitor voltage, right? Then, the RMS noise power, this is RMS noise voltage, RMS noise voltage. If I square it, it's a power, right? It becomes a KT of C, square root KT of C. This is model. This is the OKTR DF, right? This is a square. This is power, right? This is a white noise. It has we assume white noise. No, white noise, right? This is my white noise, huh? So it extends up to infinite frequency. However, there is a low pass filtering, right? That low pass filter cuts this bandwidth, right? Because of this low pass filter, this white noise is 4KTR. And the output, only this much output shows up at the capacitor, across the capacitor, right? That area is KT of C. This area. Then I know this is 4KTR. Then what's my bandwidth? Oh, my bandwidth should be something like that, equivalently. This should be 1 over 4 RC, right? If my bandwidth is 1 over 4 RC, the area should be, if I multiply this thing and this thing, I got the KT of C as the power. So let's do it to the calculation. See this HF, this is the RMS noise power. This is just 1 plus J omega RC, right? 1 over SRC. This HF is just transfer function of VO, Vout, divided by this noise voltage, right? This noise input here. So my Vout is this transfer function times input noise voltage. This is summer noise of resistor. Okay, I want to calculate the RMS power. Then I integrate the output power spectral density square with in hertz, right? DF is in hertz. So this is output power spectral density is input power spectral density times HF square. Okay. This is nothing but 4KTR, right? And then this thing HF square is just this one. This should be 1 plus omega RC square, right? That's HF square. Now I need to calculate the 2 pi F in terms of F, right? 2 pi RC F square. See, what's that value? See, integration 0 to infinite 1 plus 2 pi RC F 스퀘어, 예? DF. Say I will convert to pi RCF into tangent theta. Then my DF equal to pi RC. This is one of cosine square, right? Cosine theta square. So I substitute this one here, then this is my d theta from 0 to 90 degree, right? In terms of theta. So this is 1 plus tangent square theta and sec square theta. 2 pi RC d theta. So turns out to be this is also sec square. So my 2 pi RC, half pi, right? So should be 1 over RC. Yeah, that's why I got just a KT of C, okay? Yeah, this white noise, 4 KTR. Yeah, it's multiplied by bandwidth is a cut. Effective bandwidth is a cut by 1 over 4 RC. Okay? This area turns out to be KT of C. Yeah, this is my output noise power. Question. 민건호. No question. 알라이, so this is spy simulation, actually in Sigma spy, sir. Let's see, how can I do spy simulation? Yeah, this is the title. And voltage source. Oh yeah, I have a voltage source in 0 AC 0 or in 0 AC 0. It's a spy simulation. I mean AC frequency response. Node in here, in out register, or very large register. This is out node, and then capacitor is there. C1 top. Yeah, this is my circuit. So I put that noise, V out, V I, oh yeah, V I, decade, 10K. Now this is from 1 Hz to 10K Hz, right? I put 10 points up to decade, right? So this is 10, 100, 1K. 1, 2, 3, 4. So I will have 40 frequency points, right? Because I put 10 frequency points in each decade of frequency. So, yeah, here see, then what's the output? I think this is output noise, right? This is output noise. My output noise is a volt square there. Actually, this is a power spectrum density of output voltage. Actually, this is 2. I think this is output. Okay. We can put some input. Yeah, this output noise. See, I just got that output F1 V out square something something. I put in Excel and make a integration in terms of frequency. So I will get around the KT of C value here. So this is integration certain frequency from very low frequency of the V out F square. Okay. This V out F square is here. So this is just integration of that area, right? Yeah, for this 10 gigaohm, 1 pop, the KT of C noise is, this square root KT of C noise is 64 microvolt RMS. Pretty large register, right? What's bandwidth? Bandwidth around 100 kilohertz, right? It is kilohertz. This all? Oh no, it is all 100 hertz, right? 100 hertz. Yeah, bandwidth. This noise bandwidth is called 4 RC. This is different from 1 of 2 pi RC, right? Because of square operation. Yeah, this is 6, around 6.28 or something. This is slightly larger than this normal bandwidth. Yeah, what's this noise bandwidth? Yeah, if I multiply this thing, and then this is 4 times 10 to the minus 3. What is this thing? 250 hertz, right? My noise bandwidth is 250 hertz. Should be around there. Around here. 250 hertz. That's my noise bandwidth, 1 of 4 RC. Okay? Hmm. 아까, 그러니까, 지금, 제 오메가 1 플러스 제 오메가 RC 할 때 이 밴드위스는 1 플러스 오메가 RC 제곱분의 1 그러니까 얘가 스퀘어루트 2분의 1 이거였죠? 마이너스 3dB 프리퀀시 그러면 오메가 RC가 1이 되는 주파수가 그게 바로 F-3dB는 2파이 RC분의 1 이렇게 됐죠, 그죠? 근데 얘는 아까 저기 어떻게 됐죠? 인티그레이션을 뭘 했잖아? 어디 갔나? 인티그레이션 그렇죠 그냥 인티그레이션을 해버렸어 무슨 말인가 뭐? 인티그레이션 0에서 무한대까지 1 플러스 2파이 RC F의 제곱 DF 화이트 노이즈인데 그냥 요거 인티그레이션을 했더니 이게 1 of 4 RC가 됐다는 거죠 뭐가 계산 방법이 약간 달라 그죠? 이 에어리어를 그냥 계산해버렸어 에어리어 제곱한 에어리어를 계산했죠 얘는 요 값이 되는 그걸 마이너스 3dB 되는 프리퀀시 포인트를 계산해 놓고 얘는 뭐 이걸 통째로 적분을 했더니 얘 면적이 얼마일까? 그 여기다가 화이트 노이즈를 물론 곱했겠죠 화이트 노이즈를 곱했더니 1 of 4 RC를 자기 밴드윗으로 하면 되더라 아유 민건홍 오케이 정경원 뉴턴 alright yeah in the 그렇죠 로페스 필터 되는 거 서멀 노이즈 항상 RC 회로가 있고 거기 화이트 저항에 있는 화이트 노이즈가 캐패시터에 얼마만큼 나타나느냐 그게 K 오브 C만큼 나타난다는 거지 Yeah, this is another spice net list let's see Yeah, so you can put something like that So I specify Actually, there are two ways, right? Oh, this is for H-spice. This is H-spice method. This is sigma-spice method. In the sigma-spice, I put it like that. Down noise, output noise, input noise, decade 10, from 1 Hz to 10 kHz. So, let's see. Then, see, I'll put equivalent input noise and output noise, right? Now, this is just see. Yeah, this is sample hold circuit, right? I apply some signal there, right? VDD, zero. Yeah, the noise across this sample capacitor is KT over C. Yeah, noise bandwidth is defined to be this zero output spectral density times the noise bandwidth. That's output noise power. The ratio of output noise power divided by DC noise power spectral density. That's 1/4 RC, right? It is FC. Yeah, slightly. Oh, is this? Is it 4? MBW should be 4 RC, right? Oh, sorry. This is 1/4 RC. This is 1/2 pi RC, right? What is this? Just 2. This is larger than FC. Okay, let's talk about the MOSFET noise. Two components: thermal noise, flicker noise. Yeah, thermal noise. This is thermal motion, right? This is my thermal noise. And the other is a flicker noise. Flicker. Yeah, thermal noise is related to resistor. Yeah, when the MOSFET is operating in a triode or saturation region, we can think of MOSFET as a resistor, a sheet, resistor sheet. So if the, because see, in the MOSFET, there is a depletion region, p-type electrically neutral region, and then there is a sheet charge here, right? Inversion electron. Those are electron sheet. So it flows current in response to the electric field from drain to source, right? So, this inversion charge, channel inversion charge, it consists of free electrons, right? It's similar to a resistor. Then, if we define an average resistance value, R average, then the thermal noise current will be 4KT over R. Yeah, this same as the thermal noise voltage, the power spectral density is 4KT times R. So we want to calculate this average resistance of MOSFET in the saturation region, because MOSFET works in saturation for amplifier. So what's the average resistance of MOSFET in the saturation region? Yeah, it depends on proportional to channel length. Yeah, this is channel length, right? Inversely proportional to channel width. The channel width is there. And then inversely proportional to conductivity. So average conductivity along this channel length. Yeah, the average conductivity is 1 over L for 0 to L dy conductivity. Its conductivity is just inversion charge density at the y point times mobility. Yeah, that's conductivity, right? If I have a large density of inversion charge here, I will have a large conductivity. Okay? Now it's proportional to mobility. Then this inversion charge in the saturation region is defined by this is the inversion charge at the source side of a channel, y equals 0. And then in a long channel theory, it has a square root 1 minus 1 y of L dependence. Inversion charge is almost 0 at the drain. then this is just integration of this integration 1 minus y of L dy, right? So this is only 2/3 L or something like that, 2/3 L. So that's why my average conductivity is 2/3. It's 2/3. How come 2/3? Yeah, I think it's mu cox vgs minus vth. Okay. So my average resistance is this one, and then if I put it in a power spectral density of noise current, I just get this one. This is 4 kT and this is 8 kT. Yeah. So, yeah, this is 4 times kT of 4 kT of this is 2/3 mu cox W of L VGS minus VTH. You can see this is GM, right? 2/3 GM. Is it right? In the saturation region, that's my GM, right? This is GM. 2/3 GM. Okay. Yeah, the this thermal noise power spectral density is 4 kT times R average, right? What's this value? This value is R average is let's see, R average is you know, this is 3 over 2 1 over GM. Okay, is it right? Yeah. So this is 3 over 2 4 kT. It is right, R average. Yeah, 4 kT R average. This R square, right? So this should be 3 over 2, 1 over GM. Yeah, 3 over 2. 2, so 2 over 3. Yeah. Okay. Question. 정경원, any question? 반비례하지, 반비례. 예. 그치. 그러니까 이게 저 전류 흘리는 거, 그죠? 전류 흘리는 데하고만 관계가 있잖아요. 그러니까 지금 MOSFET 이걸 어떤 한계의 저항판이라고 보는 거죠. 디플리션 차지는 이 저항 전압 전류 관계 일단 관계가 없잖아. 캐패시던스는 만들어내겠지만. 지금 여기서는 그때는 전류가 0이라고 가정하고 있어요. 그 모델은 없어. 여기서는 그 저 스트롱 인버전 이 식도 그렇고 다 스트롱 인버전에서 지금 식을 유도했어요. 위기 인버전은 아직 모르지 뭐. 위기 인버전 식을 다시 만들어야겠죠. 익스포넨셜 뭐니까 뭘 새로 만들어야겠죠. 그래서 이 식은 거기서만 쓴다. 스트롱 인버전, 세츄레이션 리전. 3분의 2가 saturation 리전이에요. 오케이. So let's move to flicker noise. Yeah, flicker noise is related to surface state. No, surface state is surface state, 표면. 표면. 오오, how can I write the 표면? 나 표면. This single crystal structure has a very regular forms, and then when we apply oxygen into silicon surface, this crystal structure becomes a amorphous silicon oxide. Okay, this is a crystalline. Crystalline. Okay. Yeah, this is a very crystalline structure, has a very regular. This one is very irregular. So very regular silicon covalent bond stops at the boundary between silicon oxide and silicon, right? So in here, so there may be some dangling bond in the silicon. Say, so, you know, the inversion electron just passes through there, right, to conduct the current. It flows the current on the surface of silicon, just below this gas oxide, right? Then some free electrons can be captured by those bond, right? You know, this silicon atom wants eight valence electrons around it, right? So sometimes it capture the passing free electron. Then it just captures, and then sometimes it can be released, and then flow again. So it contributes the drain current. That's it's kind of random motion, just capturing and releasing the channel electron by those dangling bond. That's a flicker noise. So, you know, the large time constant, those dangling bond has different capture time. If capture time is very long, it corresponds to low frequency noise. It captures a long time and then release it. So the density of state, say, it is something like that. Say, capture time, it has, this is a capture time. The density of state is something like that. I mean, many surface state has a long capture time. Short capture time has only the density of, density is small. So, it's something like one of F dependence, okay? So noise power spectral density is proportional to one of F. No, this is noise current, power spectral density of noise current is proportional to one of F. Because long time constant dangling bond has large density, okay? Density of long capture time has a large density. It is so many long capturing states on the surface. This noise current corresponds to very short capture time. It just capture and then release it very quickly. So high frequency noise is smaller, but low frequency noise is pretty large, because most of the surface state by the dangling bond, the capturing time is very long. Okay? Yeah, it's almost proportional to drain current. So we have two components, 4 kT, 4 kT, 2/3 GM. 2/3 GM, right? This is thermal noise. KF times ID AF of frequency. AF. There is some constant here too. We can change this exponent also. Yes, there is some different model, GM square or something. This Bode long channel model, we can use two models. I mean, Sigma Spice, we use only this model. Yeah, so, yeah, see, in level 55, we can use KF is this one, my AF is close to one. Now this AF is this thing, right? EF. I think this is a Sigma, H Spice, EF. We don't use EF in Sigma Spice, okay? Yeah, this is H Spice value. Yeah, those are for certain process, certain 0.3 micron process. Okay? AF is close to 1. AF. EF is, should be close to 1. Okay, question. 정경원, did you ask question? Huh? Oh, you asked the question already. Then, Yun Yerim, your turn. No question yet? Okay. So, let's go, move. Oh, this is already time. Okay. Yeah, let's start here.